nutrition, especially in the cancer patient support group, you know, there are several people who's putting there all of the nutrition, all of the protocols of other doctors. Okay, appreciate it. There's a paleo diet, there's an Atkins diet. Me and my husband back then, in Montalban,
yes, Rizal. Yes, Montalban Rizal.
So this was like, I think, 8 years ago. So I had the talk in Montalban, Rizal, and in front of me was a fat woman. And then she came up to me and she said, Doctora, do you remember me? And I said, no, I cannot remember you. And she said, I was your patient a couple of years ago, and I just wanted to tell you personally, thank you for helping me. And I was putting in my head, who is this patient? Who is this patient? Because I have a very sharp memory. So sometimes I can really tell who they are. She told me, the first time she told me, di mo ako maalala, Doktora, binigyan mo nga ako ng pizza. It was a slice of pizza. So the history with this is that back then, when I was starting, I was working with my dad, allowed all of them to eat all types of food. So we allowed them to eat rice, bread, processed food. And just with the protocol that I have, I see results, but it's not as dramatic, you know, when I remove some of the food. And then when we started removing the rice, anything that is sweet, we saw results like it was very, very dramatic. Siguro mga after 1 month, we saw results as fast as 1 month. So that's why for those people who are very skeptic, I only have one thing to tell you. Try it first. So now, if you cannot do the entire protocol, it's up to you naman. I have never forced anyone. When we talk about nutrition, especially cancer cells, they love sugar. Anything that is sweet, anything that is easily converted to sugar, we usually don't advise. Like rice, bread, sweet potatoes, and another are processed food. They're really bad for us. So when it comes to the processed food, they are converted to a very harmful substance in our body, lalo na yung mga bacon, diba? Yung mga processed food na yan, yung mga merong nitrosamines, you call them, nitrates. So we eat them and then they are converted to nitrosamines. Pag naka-convert yan sa nitrosamines, it's a primary cause of stomach cancer. So usually talaga, we do not allow processed food. What is the diet now? Majority of the diet should be rich in good fats. Ano ba yung mga good fats? Avocado, virgin coconut oil, butter, olive oil. Yan, mga matataas ang mga fats yan. And then, green leafy vegetables. Of course, always green leafy vegetables. So, yung mga malunggay, yan, alugbati, yan. Dapat yan ang kinakain ninyo. Fish. So the smaller the fish, the better for us. Kasi pagka smaller yung fish, mas konti yung exposure niya sa heavy metals. Kasi ang ating dagat, they have a lot of heavy metals, right? There's a lot of contamination with mercury. And mercury has been proven to cause cancer. And in so many ways, it can also cause dementia. So yung mga yan, hindi talaga maganda sa atin yan. Next is that we have to eat red meat. Now, red meat, okay, meat from animals, these are whole proteins, complete proteins. So the plants, they have proteins as well, but they are incomplete. Okay, the animal meat, they are complete. For me, as long as it's organic, it's grass-fed, there's no antibiotics, no vaccines has been given to the animals, you can give it. Now, crabs, diba? Yung mga grazers, yung iba ayaw nila. Well, this is your discretion, ano, with the shrimps, with the crabs. Usually, yung ibang patient, kasi madumi yung pinagkukunan nila, so na kinakain ng mga crabs, kinakain ng mga shrimp. So usually yung iba, ayon na nilang kainin. Well, that's your discretion again. Okay? Sa akin, I allow it as long as they know where it came from. So kung malinis naman yung lugar, so you can eat crabs as long as you don't have any allergies to them.
However, he feels weaker, you have to tell him to eat. There's really no way out of this, Kamo. Kasi when you do the diet, yung diet kasi the Dr. Farah diet, kasi bawal sa akin ng rice and bread. Masarap. Okay? So you really have to tell the patient, okay? Kailangan mo talagang kumain. You are allowed to eat 10 times a day. Now, kung talagang mahina siya, spirulina. spirulina can help you because it's high in protein, so maganda siya.